Here's what I believe. You don't have to agree. First impressions count. The last impression is everything.
I have been speaking to groups for years, since 1981, and I have always had success. And that's really not bragging. That's saying if I've been at this long, that you can depend on my product, you can depend on my presentation, and you can depend on my professional courtesy to what it is that you're looking for at an event. I mean, I'm just good at it. It's as simple as that. You can't deny it. It's not just about having no arms. In fact, that's kind of what's ironic, is it's not about having no arms. It's about the professional product that I deliver every single time I take a stage, whether I'm talking to five people or 5,000, doesn't matter. I am the guy that you can depend on. I promise you, you will not regret the decision.
My wife and I were in an antique store one day. We're cruising around. She's on one side of the store. I'm on the other. These old guys are following me around. And they're looking at me, because every time I look at them, they pretend to be looking at something else. Came around a corner, there was a pair of mannequin arms on a bookshelf. So I grab one under my chin, because that's how I carry stuff, right? I shouted across the store, "Darlene, I may have found them." What a place to find them. Who knew? Old people stare too. I find this fascinating. I think little kids stare because they haven't learned manners, and old people stare because they've quit them. Do you know anybody like that? They just get old and crusty. I don't care what I say. Yeah, you know someone like that? I was very spoiled when I got here. I'm not going to lie about this. I got picked up by a limo. Woohoo. That was nice. I like limos every now and then. Don't do them all the time. I don't do cabs, because strangely, they don't stop when you go. I rent over 100 cars a year and have been for now over 20 years. Can you imagine, though, just the little thing alone of giving them your driver's license and credit card and taking the keys in your toes and driving away with your foot on the wheel? It's like those MasterCard commercials. Priceless. Drive-thrus, those are hilarious. I went to Timmy's just around the corner yesterday for lunch. Could you just, when you walk up, they don't see you coming. They see the car coming. You drive up to the window, that'll be $6. Here! Oh, a guy said to me once, it's funnier if you're in the car behind you. Right. Because all you see is the foot going out the window, you know, a couple of feet grabbing the double-double, and away I go.
You have to admit, it's a compelling thought to think that somebody can live life without arms. That must provide some clues. And I just like sharing. Just like helping people get better, you know, improve their lives. And I've been doing it since 1981, so I don't think I really got to pick. It kind of cheesy, but it picked me, really.
He was the happiest human being I'd ever seen in my entire life, and he was so happy, he was actually annoying. There's a lot of you in the building today. No, you are, you're happy people, I've been seeing you. Do you ever occur to you that when you're that happy, people want to smack you? Imagine my frustration. I've got no arms. All I can do is be resentful. Anyway, I am on the entire front cover of the newspaper. Bigger than life. Almost nude. Wearing a diaper, yes, but a black photographic bar across my eyes so nobody will recognize who I am. Really? And I was growing up in rural Canada where nothing ever happened, and I was butt ugly. Now, I know we're not supposed to call people ugly. I understand that, but I felt ugly. You ever done this? Sorry, this is really honest. You ever spot a baby in a stroller? And you go, look at the baby in the stroller, and your first thought is, man, that's an ugly baby. You've done that, haven't you?
It was obvious what I sucked at. Sports. I was terrible at sports. Soccer, awesome. Bonus, never got the penalty for touching the ball with my hands.
Well, I think people should listen to me because I've got a high degree of credibility when it comes to my material. And if really I'm just talking about making people better people, I'm not saying I'm perfect, but obviously my story doesn't involve just me. It involves somebody behind the scenes. That's why I talk about my parents. That's why I talk about teachers. That's why I talk about influences in my life. And if I can be the same kind of person in someone else's life, then that fulfills not only a professional role, but, you know, I'm a speaker. That's what I do. I'm a professional speaker.
People are looking at me all the time like, don't you miss having arms? No. They never grew. Now, are you thinking what I'm thinking you're thinking now? You're thinking, oh, you're just being a speaker, putting a positive spin on things. No, I was a person before I became a speaker. And you may own a home hardware outlet, but you are a person before you are an owner. Does that make sense? I want you to picture this, how weird it is for me to be in front of you today, not only having made a career out of motivational speaking, but to talk to an incredible amount of young people, old people, people in general today that are going to be spending the rest of your careers worrying about what is on the outside of people. So I'm not going to tell you how to do that. That's why you go to the Paul Mitchell schools. I'm going to talk about what I understand about where beauty actually radiates from. But my two cents is really quite simple. I believe who we are is not what people see when we first meet. I believe who we are is deeper than that. In fact, I have hands, they're right here. And I believe when that happened, my so-called handicap disappeared.
Well, I think my material has a little bit of credibility when it comes to attitudinal discussion because I'm living it every single day. I try to play down with a little bit of humility. I try, you know, but let's be honest. When you do what I do, when you drive a car, when you play the drums, when you play the piano, there's a skill set involved that comes not from just the feet. It comes from the core of who I am, and that is attitude. And attitude can play a huge role in making our world a better place to live. I mean, it's really not a cliche if you believe that it works. Right?
Oh God, was there ever a sentence constructed that should be turfed from the English language or any language for that matter? There's nothing I can do. Do you know, that is just an attitude choice. There's always something you can do. Always. That's what makes being in a room with people like you so special today. Because you see what you do is not just something that is warm and fuzzy. You see it as a defining of change, of growth, in our society, don't you? That's what I think of when I think of people like you. If you can't excel at something, why even bother to try and do it? Well, I guess if you're looking for Olympic gold, that's one kind of attitude to have. But what about the idea that not everybody needs to win a gold medal to be successful? What about the idea that you don't need to climb Everest to know what it's like to look out on the world and see nothing but beauty? What about the idea that within all of us is a standard that doesn't necessarily have to match other people's standards? That maybe the bottom line is simply, does it make us smile? And does it bring us joy? And if it does those two things, can it not even heal us? Can it not even cure us? Can it not even make our worlds better simply because of something that we would have never thought possible? Celebrate who you are, because you deserve it. And while we're at it, make sure you learn a couple of things while you're here. Because there's a lot of people that believe in certain things, like that lady in the kitchen. You know what? I got pretty short toes. She wasn't wrong. It just occurred to me one day, maybe I should have got a second opinion.
I stand against people that have not been able to get over stuff. That's probably the one that bugs me the most. I had to get over blaming having no arms on whatever wicked monster was out there creating my life, because the irony is, whatever it was that made me this way is what gave me the awesome life that I've got. If people could just see the opposite side of what they complain about, then they would live life with more joy, with more abundance, and with more success.
Every one of you in this room has a story that you should start writing down right now. Promise me you will do this. Promise me you'll start journaling in your life. Because you may think, well, I don't have anything to write about. Want to bet? How do you think this company started? With somebody who believed in something that was probably said to them a million times. Are you crazy? Yeah, you know what? It's good to be crazy. But maybe what they're actually telling you is not that you suck, but that maybe you need to work to be awesome.
I think what's really funny is people remember me. And you know, you think, well, they remember me because I play the drums with my feet or play the piano with my toes. Oh, you know, those are part of the act. But I think what people remember me is they can relate to my challenges. Who in the world does not have an obstacle they've had to overcome in their life? And when they see that I've done it, it reminds them that they too can do it. And it is a personal thing. I'm not talking to 5,000 people in a big theater. I'm talking to one person in the middle of 5,000 people. Every single person in the room gets this. Somehow, on a very deep and personal level, they understand that challenges can be overcome. And it's not a cliche. So it's not about a disability. It's about everybody has something. And that's what I remind people, that we can all get over those somethings, all of us.
So I would come home every day, and instead of just the old Tommy Dorsey or Glenn Miller, I just played Rush over and 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 over. All right, you can clap for that if you'd like. Thank you.
My story is real. That's the difference. I think that really is what people look at their own lives and question. That's really what I'm after. I'm not trying to make people think I'm better than them. In fact, that's the irony, is I'm living life in a way that is real. You can't argue with the facts. And I think that's why people need to consider what I've got to say. And of course, that's what meeting planners, that's what organizers, that's what event planners are looking for. Somebody with a degree of credibility, but also somebody that's going to leave people on a very high note, on a very positive thought process as they go into a convention or head out into the world after being at one. That's what I do.
But I want to thank you, because you, this is the truth, I make nothing up and I never patronize. You restore my faith in your generation. You will make the world a better place. And God bless you doing it. Thanks for having me here. Thank you very much. Come on up, brother. Thank you very much. Love you, man.